Hello guys, I hope you all are doing good. In today's video, we will be talking about another thread synchronization primitive, which is called semaphore. So as you remember, in our previous video, we talked about locks and auto reset event and manual reset event. Those are also thread synchronization primitives. Like lock allows only one thread to enter into critical section at a time. So if there are more than one threads who wants to use a critical resource or who wants to enter into a critical section, only one will be allowed at a time. Others will wait, and then when the one who is using that or who is inside this critical region, when he leaves that critical section, the waiting thread will be allowed to enter. Just remember that when a thread blocks, that thread is not using any CPU. That thread is not actually in the ready thread list of thread scheduler in Windows. But he's there, he's not dead. It's just not using any CPU. The semaphore actually allows n number of threads to enter into the critical section at the same time. That means you can have as many threads as you want running into your critical section at the same time. For example, let's say you have a club where you have a maximum capacity. Let's say you have a club where five people can enter at the same time and the rest of the people will have to wait into a queue, and whenever a person in the club leaves the club, the slot becomes available and the waiting person will be allowed to enter into the club. And that's the same theory actually which works with semaphore. Semaphore are kind of smart integers, like auto reset event and manual reset events are like smart booleans. So if we take an example with our pool example, if we look at our pool example here, let's say I have many threads. Where are my threads? T1, T2, T3 and T4. So I have T1, T2 up to so many threads. This is our club, and we allow only three people at the same time. It's a very special club. Only three threads can be allowed at the same time. Rest will have to wait. So that means if I just remove this, and let's say in the start all three slots are available. So T1, T2 and T3, they will be allowed and they will be gone from the queue list or from our queue. They are here and enjoying. But let's see, now T2 leaves. T2 is done with the club. He is tired. He wants to go home. He is drunk. That means T2 is gone from our club, and then one slot becomes available. Remember, we have only maximum three can be into the club at the same time. T2 is gone, now T4 can enter. T4 can enter here. T4 comes and he is enjoying now. Others will have to wait. So T4 is not waiting any longer. Now let's see, T1 and T4, they are done. They are done, so they are gone. T3 is still there. He is having fun. So now T1 and T4 is done. They can do whatever they want. Doesn't matter. So now two slots are available. That means T5 and T6 can enter. T5 and T6. They can enter. And they are not waiting any longer. And so on and so forth. You get the idea. That's how it works, the semaphore. But if it was a lock, if we had, instead of semaphore, if we had lock system, then only one thread can enter into our critical section or critical region. So a semaphore of one maximum count of one is actually a kind of lock. The only difference is that the thread who doesn't own the semaphore can also release this semaphore, which you cannot do in the lock. If you in lock, the thread which takes the lock has to release the lock, otherwise you get exception. Like, let's see, let's go back to our Visual Studio, and now we can write an example and see how it works actually practically or in program. So what we are going to do, we are going to create a semaphore equals to new semaphore also lives in system.threading namespace. What you do, you actually give it an initial count, that means how many slots are available initially. In our case, we want same number of slots are available, and the maximum count is also 3. That means we are saying here the maximum number of threads who can enter into our critical region is 3, and all 3 slots are available in the start. Let's see, and then we create, let's see, 10 threads. We are creating an array of threads. Let's create 10. Then we create them. We have to new them up. Threads dot length. No. Threads dot length. And then we create our threads. New thread. Can enter club like this, and in our enter club method, which is our critical section, let's pass semaphore here, object arg. Remember, we will be calling, this is a delegate to thread, parameterized thread delegate. You remember? If you don't remember, please do watch my video where I tried to explain how to create threads. So we can print out like ID of the thread. We can say thread dot current thread, say static property, then we get the manage thread ID, and we write arrived and waiting, something like this, and then we get our semaphore. You remember this object arg, this is our semaphore which we will be passing arg as semaphore. We don't have to check for null, we know what we are doing. So what we do first is semaphore.wait1. We are waiting here until a slot becomes available, and then we can write this thread got or entered, we can say n entered, and then he will be enjoying. Let's see, thread dot sleep. This thread has come into our pool, and now he is doing whatever he wants, and we are simulating his time just by thread dot sleep. And then he is done. Then he will quit or exit. And when you are exit, then he will release the semaphore. That's it. Like this, what actually happens whenever a thread is entered into the critical section after wait 1, the count is decreased, the number of slots available decreases, and whenever we call release, the number of slots available that increases, and whenever the number of available slots is 0, the thread will be blocked here. So the thread will arrive and will wait until a slot becomes available. Okay, now we are back in our main method. We have created 10 threads. Let's start them. Start, and now we want to pass the parameter, which is semaphore. We will be passing semaphore. And then let's join. So let our main thread join them. That means our main thread will be waiting until these all 10 threads are finished. And we can write here all are done, something like this. Yeah, so this looks okay. We have created semaphore with maximum count of 3 and 3 slots available in the start. Then we have declared an array of 10 threads. We have created them. Now we are starting them, and then main thread is waiting here. Let's see, F5. Three arrived and waiting, four arrived and waiting. Now let me see, is it? Three arrived, four entered, five entered, and three entered. At a time, only three can enter. So number four entered, number five entered, number three entered. All of them, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, all these other seven threads, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, they are waiting. Now 4 exit, that means one slot becomes available, the 6 got entered. 5 exit, 7 entered, and so on and so forth, all are done. This is basically is the semaphore. You can allow as many threads you want to enter into a critical section at the same time. While in lock, only one thread can enter at the same time. So if you had initial count 1 and maximum count 1, this is kind of lock, that with only one difference. In lock, the thread which owns the lock has to release the lock, but semaphore can be released by any thread. Like we had semaphore here, I could say semaphore dot release here. That's it for semaphore. I hope you learned something and you understand the concept of semaphore. If you have any questions, do write into the comment section, and I will see you guys in my next video. Until then, bye bye.